Joining me to take a look at this two-day meeting is an Associate Professor of the Department of History and Strategic Studies, University of Lagos, Dr. David Awurawo. Thank you so much for joining us on the News at 10.
Thank you.
What do you think is significant about this meeting with Morocco for us at this time? That was quite a delegation that you saw there, you know, that the king had sent. So what's significant for us now?
Well, what is significant is that two African states are forging closer ties, and that should be gratifying. And then they've signed agreements on different issues, education cooperation, economic cooperation, oil and gas, and, you know, and things like that. These are things from which both countries are expected to benefit. So to that extent, it is significant for both countries. And in any case, for a long time, ties have not been this close. So when two countries are forging closer ties to promote cooperation for mutual benefit, it's always a good thing.
Yeah, well, you said something now, that ties have not been this close. You see observers and watchers wondering why Morocco is courting us at this time, and why we're courting them. For instance, you see that there's been this bid for them to return to ECOWAS. Senegal, Cote d'Ivoire aren't quite as happy to have them return. Do you think this is all, you know, in aid of that?
Well, yes, to a large extent. If you look at the timing, the Moroccan delegation came to Nigeria in December 2016. Mm. In January 2017, Morocco was granted a return to the AU. Well, we say a return because Morocco was never really a member of the AU. It was a member of the old AU. Broke, you know, left in 1984,
exited, yeah.
Yes. Then returned to join the AU in 2017. Although there are still some problems along that and because of certain disagreements between the position of Morocco and the rest of, you know, members of the African Union. Mm-hmm. Again, Morocco applied to join ECOWAS in February 2017.
So are you tying the applications to return to the EU?
They are intertwined. They are linked. Oh. You see, this is just the calculation. Morocco understands that Nigeria is the dominant country in West Africa, and that Nigeria is the country that will likely, if Morocco will join, will be allowed to join. Ultimately, Nigeria will play a significant role. And if there's a country that would perceive a threat to its dominance, you know, at the forefront will be Nigeria. Of course, Senegal, Cote d'Ivoire, some other countries will also be there. So if Morocco is able to get Nigeria to its side, or get Nigeria enmeshed in a web of activities such as the agreements you're signing now,
yeah,
it will make it, you know, easier for Morocco, you know, to join the ECOWAS. But I must add that this, you know, quickness, this alacrity about just granting Morocco to join the ECOWAS, countries should be very careful.
But when you look at it, it's the Economic Community of West African States. So already that puts a question mark. Even though some analysts say, well, it's just a tag, it doesn't matter. They might need to, you know, make some changes to accommodate Morocco if they do join.
Yes, technically there is no problem. You know, ECOWAS is a regional organization. In international relations, a regional organization is anything that is less than global. Usually, they are geographically contiguous, but sometimes they are not. So Morocco joining, is not a problem as far as geographical location is concerned. But there are other fundamental issues, such as regional organizations like ECOWAS, where, although they normally will commence with economic cooperation, cultural cooperation, things like that, the ultimate objective is political community. So the question to ask is, if and when ECOWAS metamorphoses to a political community, will Morocco be part of it?
Mm.
When they want to adopt a common currency, will Morocco be, you know, on the same plane with African countries along that? Those are issues.
Well, those are all questions to ask. But bringing it back to us now, looking at the agreements that were signed today on energy infrastructure, agriculture, we see us getting into such agreements. Do you think we will gain as much as we hope to gain on paper with Morocco finally now?
Well, we should gain a lot. You know, there is one problem that our foreign policy has had over the years, and that is not conducting our relations along the principle of quid pro quo, something for something.
Mm.
You know, we need to do a careful analysis of what we stand to gain. All countries conduct their relations along the line of national interest. Nigeria can be too altruistic in its own approach to the conduct of foreign relations. That is what needs to be done. There needs to be a careful calculation of what we stand to gain, you know. For instance, regarding ECOWAS, Nigeria should be worried. because Morocco has a fairly vibrant, producing sector, I mean, industrial sector. And that will rival Nigeria and all that. So what needs to happen now is for Nigeria to do a careful analysis of its interest, of what it stands to gain from all of these agreements before jumping into uncharted waters.
All right. Associate Professor in the Department of History and Strategic Studies of UNILAG, thank you so much for joining us on the News at 10. Dr. David Awurawu, thank you so much.
Thank you.